Is your house not selling? Let's talk about why. Hi, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Samantha Pearlman and I'm a realtor located in Central New Jersey. Every week I post videos about what it's like to live and work here and guidance on buying, selling, and investing in the area. If this is something that interests you, consider hitting that subscribe button below and the bell so you don't miss the new videos I release every week. Chances are, if you're watching this video, you put your home up for sale and it didn't sell for some reason. You're probably feeling frustrated, tired, anxious, depressed, and maybe even angry about it. You put your home out on the market and you expected it to sell so that you can move on to the next chapter of your life. Instead, you watched your home go off the market, expired, and unsold. You're probably asking yourself, what happened? Why didn't it sell? Why didn't I get more showings? Where were all the offers? Where are all the buyers? First, I just want to say I am so sorry that your home didn't sell. Let's talk about the five different parts of the process that have to work together to get your home sold. Number one, price. I'm just gonna go ahead and start with the toughest one first, the one that the sellers really don't wanna talk about. You have to have the right price on your home in order for it to sell. And in most cases, if it's expired off the market, your price was just too high for the market to support it. Now, this could have happened for a variety of reasons. It could have been the price that your agent actually recommended and they didn't have a good handle on the market. It could be the price that you insisted on and your agent just wasn't strong enough to tell you the truth. Or you could be in a shifting market where home prices are going down. Now, if you want to learn how to price your home properly, I've actually made a whole video about it. I'll link it above and below. Go ahead and check that out. Number two, presentation. Presentation is your area of control as the homeowner. Making your home look more desirable than all the other homes on the market is an effort well worth it. Things like decluttering, cleaning, moving furniture around, doing some light staging, opening up curtains and blinds, and properly preparing your home for showings is a key factor in getting your home sold. You might even consider making some affordable upgrades or small repairs around the home to make it more enticing to buyers. Check out the video linked above on how to prep your home for sale. In fact, I have a whole free guide that you can download today on how to prep your home for sale. Click the link in the description box to download your free copy today. Number three, marketing. Marketing is your realtor's job and it consists of many different components. Not only is your agent's job to provide maximum exposure for your home, getting it out there where it's going to be seen by the most amount of people, they must also put out their enticing photographs and descriptions and make sure to list all the attributes of your home correctly. The goal is to entice the buyers to want to come see the home in person. It's also important to understand, and your agent should know this, exactly where to spend their time, effort, energy, and money on marketing your home. Now, it's in my experience that almost every single buyer starts their home search online. And in fact, National Association of Realtors statistics show that 50% of the homes every buyer has purchased, they found themselves directly online. So your agent's job is to really highlight your property the best possible way through all the online platforms. A big part of that is going to be the photos, and that's why I always insist sellers use professional photography. The goal with online marketing, and really any marketing in general, is to entice the buyers to fall in love with the property enough to want to see it in person. Because you see, if you've properly prepared your home for sale, and you've done the marketing correctly, and you've enticed the buyers to come walk through that front door, the home's going to speak for itself. Number four, negotiation. Maybe you've done the first three things we've discussed successfully and you've actually received an offer on your property. Congratulations. But for some reason or another, the negotiation didn't go well and didn't result in an executed contract. It's important to understand that a successful negotiation is when it's a win-win on both sides, but that doesn't mean it's without compromise. Typically in a successful negotiation, both sides have had to compromise something, but they both feel very happy with the end result. That's what's going to give you an executed contract. And number five, the follow-through. Let's say you've actually got through the first four parts that we discussed today and you did get an executed contract, but for one reason or another, it didn't go through and you didn't actually close on it. It's important once you have an executed contract to work closely with your agent throughout the entire process. You want to anticipate what the next steps are and troubleshoot any possible challenges that may come up along the way. These are the five most common reasons a home doesn't sell or close. If your home has expired off the market, I want you to think long and hard about which one of these five factors may have been off for you. Think to yourself, Does any of these five factors come into play for my home? Did I price it correctly? Did I prepare it for sale correctly? Was it marketed properly? Did we negotiate the offers we got successfully? And why didn't we get to the closing table if you did get a contract? Chances are, if you think about this in a true objective form, something will come to mind. And if you're still unsure, then consult with a local real estate expert to see what their opinion on the situation is. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you found this information helpful. If you know anybody that could benefit from the things we've discussed here today, please share the video with them. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and say hello in the comments section below. My goal is to make the content you're looking for, so if you have an idea for a future video, please leave it in the comments section below. Happy house selling, and I'll see you next week.